Once again, it's Friday, fool! Welcome back to another glorious episode of It's Friday, Fool. You need this tool. This week's tool? The Task Force Fiberglass Claw Hammer. Not really. So I know you've seen a lot of my videos where I'm putting aircraft rivets in either signs or some of cutworm stuff. They're putting aircraft rivets in body panels and in seats. Well, that's my tool. The aircraft rivets are amazing. They're very simple. It's not like your standard rivets. It's not your through hole rivet like you normally see on a rivet gun. These rivets are solid aluminum and they're relatively cheap. Here, take a look. It's a solid aluminum rivet with a dome head on it. They come in different sizes and different lengths. Basically, the way these things work is you just squish it from both sides. Now, how do you do that, you say? Really? It's quite simple. On one end, you have this piece. Now, on the end of it, it's a dome, just like the rivet is, okay? This piece here, it looks familiar to a lot of you, I'm sure, goes in an air hammer. Now, you could use an air chisel, but it's not recommended. The air chisels usually have too much power, they're too fast. You kind of want something that's specifically made for the aircraft rivets. It's a little slower, you have a lot more control out of it. They are a little more expensive, but you can actually buy these pieces separate if you already have one, or if you have an air chisel that maybe you can dial down. The particular one I've got is a Blue Point, and it does have a regulator on it where you can dial this thing down a little bit, and it works well. Plain and simple, you got your air rivet gun, or chisel gun if you choose. You got the piece that goes in the end, all right? You got your rivet. Your rivet just smashes up on the end of this cup. Usually the head of the rivet is the same diameter and cup shape as the tool itself. Goes through your pieces of aluminum or steel, and then on the back side of it, all you need is some kind of buck. All right, this is a solid steel buck here. You press it against there, you use the gun, and it kind of jams it all together and smooshes the back. It kind of mushrooms the head on the back. This particular buck will make a flat head on the back side. You retain your dome-shaped rivet on the front side because of the special tool. You do a bunch of those, you got straight up aircraft rivets. Anyway, you buy the rivets by the pound, or by the ounce, or by the, you buy the rivets by the pound. They're pretty cheap, a couple bucks, you get a bunch of them. All you need is a gun, your anvils, your rivet anvils, I guess what these things are called, I don't know, and a buck, right? Pretty simple. These rivet sets work great for the tool I did a while back. The punch, the hole punch, speeds up the process. You punch the aluminum, stick the rivet in, do your job. Punch the hole, stick the rivet in, do your job, right? It's an easy deal. If you want to check out this tool, I will link it right here. All right, guys, that's it for this week. I know it's been a while, but I want to bring you good stuff, right? I don't want to be bringing you claw hammers. I want to bring you good tools. And so sometimes it may take an extra week or two for me to come up with something nice and good to bring. I mean, I could just bring you screwdrivers, but you don't want that. Thanks for joining me for another episode of It's Friday, Fool. You need this tool. As always, I'll put links in the description. For this particular tool, I'm gonna put a little bit of everything. I'm gonna put a gun in there if you wanna kinda check out what the guns cost. I'll put a kit of these in there. These are pretty inexpensive. So I'll put a kit of these in there. I'll even put some sample rivets so you can kinda see how much the rivets cost. Hey, you know what? If you're into hot rodding, you're building a hot rod, if you're into rat rods, whatever it is, and you wanna add a little flair, the aircraft rivet, it's the way to go. There's all kinds of guys using these things. Jamie Jordan that does the seats, Jeb, Greenstone from Cutworm Specialties, all these guys are using these things. They look phenomenal. You need to get you some. All right, guys, that's it for this week. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you next week. It's Friday, fool!